Hi everyone, welcome back to Gore Mountain in New York State. In the USA, it is the men's and women's snowboard big air finals from Lake Placid 2023, the FITU World University Games. Well, if you're with us for the free ski big air this morning, you'd have seen some heavy snowfall. It has thankfully eased off since the free ski finals have been completed. There's still a little bit falling, but not enough to cause any issues for the snowboarders this afternoon. They've been working on the course pretty much since the end of those free ski finals, getting the in run in good shape and the takeoff. They are pretty smooth now. The riders have had about 45 minutes training as well, so that's got the course in great condition. And there is a big, big crowd in the finish area as well. A lot of the local schools have been given the afternoon, well, the whole day off, actually, to come up and watch these big air finals today. And it's making a superb atmosphere in the finish. We've got the women's and men's snowboard big air finals. Let's get a look at some of the highlights from qualifying. Qualifying taking place yesterday. There wasn't as much snow yesterday, so it was a pretty decent set of conditions. Naomi Ekwe in third. Kari Yoshizawa in second place. Yoshizawa missing out on a medal in the slopestyle. The top qualifier, though, for this big air, Lydia Tano from Switzerland, the gold medalist in women's slopestyle. Over in the men's, third place in qualifying, Yuto Yamada from Japan. Yamada finished eighth in slopestyle. Atsuhiro Suzuki in second after qualification. And the top qualifier from the Czech Republic, Christian Salak. Very experienced rider. It's a three-run contest as we see our women's start list. Best two out of three runs are combined to get our totals, and it's those totals that we use to determine the final standings. But you have to do two different directions on your tricks. So run one, you might have to go front side. Run two, you have to go for backside trick. If you do that, then you'll get a total on the board. There's the men's start list, 12 men in finals. Martin Lelou from France will kick that off. But it is the women's finals up first, or women's run one up first, followed by the men and their first run. Then we go back to the women's first run, back to the men until we've done our three runs. There's been a lot of work on those takeoff ramps. The Arena Snow Parks team have been working on them. They put the build together. 15 meter jumps, good steep landing. The landing has a little harder after all the skiers have been landing on it, so it's pretty well packed, but ideal. Good steep landing from France, Naomi Ekwe, 22 years old. She's out of Val Thorens. She was second this week here at Lake Placid 2023 in slopestyle. Two Europa Cup wins in her career, one in slopestyle, one in big air. They came in 2020. She's dropping in on that left-hand kicker, setting up the backside trick. Back three, and that was smooth. She put that down nicely. Great landing. Decent amplitude. She's gone with a stalefish grab. Backhand on the heel edge, so her right hand on the heel edge. It is a 72.75. Naomi Ekwe likes it. Good start for the Frenchwoman. Next up, Hikari Yoshizawa from Japan. This week's been her first contest since 2021. She's a regular footer, 19 years old. Qualified through in second place. She was fourth in the slopestyle. All eyes on a medal for Yoshizawa. She sets up for the backside three as well with the Weddell grab. Nice and smooth and clean. Back three. And the judges liking that one from Yoshizawa. Puts her in the top spot. A little bit more amplitude. The last rider to go in the women's first run, Livia Tano from the Swiss Federal Institute of Technology. 20 years old, the gold medalist in slopestyle. Here at Lake Placid 2023. She's a regular footer. Left foot forward. What has she got in store on this first run? see the in run a lot smoother, a lot faster than it was for the skiers. Going for the 540. Back five with a stale fish grab. This is going to be a big score for Livia Tano. Coach is happy. And she goes 90.75. Livia Tano leads after one run. We turn our attention to the men's event. Run one, Moritz Blue finished sixth in the slope stop. He's getting the slingshot in from the back of the start house. Every little bit of speed helps. Moritz Blue, goofy footer. Can he stick this first one? No, he just about does. Wasn't the cleanest of landings, but he did hang on, going back 12. And he gets 88, Moritz Blue coming out swinging here in finals. Next up, Minsik Lee, out of the Korean National Sport University.
Let's go.
Previously, he's been known as a half-pipe rider. But showing he's got the skills in slope style, taking the gold medal here at Lake Placid 2023. He's dropping switch here. He's a regular footer, comes in switch. Oh, going for the switchback 12. He sets up switch, backside trick. Gets the melon grab, difficult to make the landing. Not going to be a super competitive score, 30.5. Go for the frontside trick on run two. You could try and improve that back 10. Yusai Kaku from Japan. Agonizingly close to a medal in the slope style. 18 years old, he's got a World Cup start this season, dropping in forwards. Going frontside. And he sticks that one down. Beautiful work from Kaku. He's got the Weddle grab. And it's into third place, 85. So superb start. Atsuhiro Suzuki. World Cup best in big air, a 16th. That was in Atlanta in 2019. So Hatsuhiro Suzuki, regular footer, drops in forwards. Oh, back 10, and he sticks it. Holds the grab throughout the trick, stomps the landing. Let's see where Hatsuhiro Suzuki places. Yeah, it's a 72.25. Sixth place. Naomi Ekwe went back three on the first run. She's in third place. Already has a silver medal at these games. So the front side rotation coming for Ekwe. She can land this. It gives her the platform to see what she can do on that run number three. Sets up for that front side rotation. The front three, she gets it right. Wasn't the smoothest front three you'll ever see, but she landed it.
Kind of coming out of that a little early on that grab, the judges definitely win.
Dale Fish, and it's 63.25 for the front three. So she's got the two different directions. She moves into first with 136. So Yoshizawa, she went back three, Weddle on the first run. 19-year-old. Wants a medal, of course she does. She missed out in slope style. She's got a first run score of 78.75. Here she goes, needs to go for the front side trick. Regular footer, dropping in forwards. Going for that front three, it was smooth, it was clean. has kept it all together. A little better than Naomi Ekwik. And it's 73.75. So she goes into the number one spot, 152.5. She's got the platform now to build on run number three. Livia Tano leads. 20-year-old gold medalist in slopestyle. She went back five on the first run. It put her into the 90s. So what's she got in terms of a frontside trick? She's a regular footer, just tightens the board up. In run is pretty bumpy, but it's running quick. Still running forwards. Front three and holds it together. Crick on run number two. She does get the grab.
My guess is she's not scored quite as high as her last backside 540 sale.
That's the Indy grab. It's not going to be in the 90s, and it's going to be very healthy. 81.75, she moves to a total of 172.5, and she leads the way after two out of the three runs.
Come on.
Now, Moritz Brew lit the contest up with an 88 on the first run. He stuck the back 12.
Good to go, 14.
He's in a medal position at the moment. He will want to get the frontside trick in on this run. He's dropping in switch here. He's going for the cap trick. Oh, he's not hit. Hang on. He has managed to grab as well. Just not able to land that cap 10. It's close though. 29.75, he's on 117.75, but he's gonna need to land that cap 10. Big, big moment here for Min-Sik Lee from Korea. Falling on the first run, he's down in 12. Absolutely has to land here if he wants to get on the podium again. He went switch back 12 on the first run. He's setting up again, dropping in switch. Can he land this switch back 12? If he can, it will be a huge score. Min-Sik Lee from Korea just hangs on. This is going to be a big, big score. Min-Sik Lee announces himself in the men's big air finals. It was close. Tiny margins in this game. His weight was just a little bit more on that right foot. Well, it's 64.75, the landing costing Min-Sik Lee. Yusai Kaku from Japan, he's got an 85 from the first run. He went front 10, and that gave him 85. Regular footer, so will he go for the backside trick? Forward, that looks to be the plan set up. Go for the back 12. Yes, he gets it. Here we go, folks. Going to move him into the lead. Kaku, the first man to land two runs and have a decent score on both runs. Will that be a medal winning run? It might well be. 87, Yusai Kaku on 172. He's in a commanding position now in the men's big air final here at Lake Placid 2023. See that snow picking up. Atsuhiro Suzuki next up. He's got a 72.25. He went back 10 on the first run. Setting up for the front side trick. Front 10, and he hangs on. Gets the tail grab with the right hand and switches up to Melon. That will help the score. I think he just avoids the hand drag on landing. Just watch the right hand. Yeah, he keeps it up off the snow. Execution, name of the game, and the judges are really going to like that. It was well executed. 92-75, he's up into second place. Well, the crowd are here in great spirits, in great voice. Put our best score down on the third run.
He's looking at the places, 63 dropping in. Good to go,
three. Naomi Ekwe in the bronze medal position. She's guaranteed a medal now, her second of these games. Can she improve and get a little better? Go for that front three. Well, I think it was grabbed a little better than the first run. She just about got a hand on the board, a stalefish grab.
You can see that stale kind of touching it behind the back binding there.
It's 55-75, so she carries forward her scores from jump one and jump two. So Yoshizawa went for the front three, but didn't really grab it on the second run. So she could try and clean that up. She got enough. She needs to find a run that in the 90s to challenge for the gold. That's not to be. Going back to the backside trick. So Yoshizawa will stay in the silver medal position. Gets on the podium. She missed out in slopestyle, but she's picked up a silver medal here. Total of 152.5. The Swiss flags are flying. Will it be a victory lap? Well, it is a victory lap, but is she going to push it? Is she just going to cruise over this jump and collect another Adirondack man? Goes for the five on. She might even go seven. No victory lap. It was full send from Livia Tano. Goes for the front side trick. Grabs the tail of the board. Snow getting a little heavier too. Heavy impact to the head. That releases the goggle lens. But Livia Tano with a super performance here at Lake Placid 2023. The women's gold medalist. 20 points clear, Livia Tano getting the job done on run one and two. She set the benchmark with a 90.75, and that was the highest individual score of the day. So Moritz Bru, 19-year-old from Germany, he's in fourth. He went cap 10 on the second run, but he didn't land it. He's got that 88 from the first run, so a huge moment. He's coming in switch again. If he can land this, there is a medal up for grabs. Can he stick it down? Yes, he can! Moritz Bru charging towards a podium. Cap 10, 80, lands its switch as well. 82.25. He's up into second place. Min-Sik Lee, best score of 64.75. That is what he's going to add to. If he can go, he needs to go deep into the 90s. Challenge and get on the podium. In fact, looking at it, he can't get on the podium, but he does land. So he can get on the podium. Sticks the double 12 down. Even if he scored 100, he wouldn't be able to do it. It's 92.75. It is a huge score, and he drops into fourth place. That is the best score of the day so far, but that second jump not scoring high enough to put Min-Sik Lee on the podium. Here is the current leader, Yusai Kaku. He's got an 85 and an 87. Will he just try and make it secure? He's got a front 10, back 12 on the board. Looking through the riders still to come. Still got Atsuhiro Suzuki, who's got a 90 on the board. He's in the bronze medal position. Yusai Kaku underway. Oh, he looks like he might come up a little short, but he doesn't. He hangs on. Great third run. Wonderful consistency. It'll be another decent score. And it's 83-25, his lowest score of the day. His first and second run scores are carried forward. Atsuhiro Suzuki in the start gate, ready to drop in. He will know he's got a bronze medal. That's in the bag. He's already picked up a bronze in slopestyle, but a gold medal could be coming his way if he throws down big and lands this third and final run. Is this for gold? Can he do it? No, it's not to be. Just reverts out a little on landing. .31.75, his total 165. Of course, he stays in third place. There's the final standings in the men's. Yusai Kaku from Japan picking up the gold medal. Two medals at these games for Naomi Ekwe. A great return, a great reward for her effort. Another hug from Livia Tano, congratulating the young French woman on her performance. Hikari Yoshizawa, the 19-year-old, hasn't competed for a couple of years, but she has returned for these VCU World University Games. Walks away with one medal, the silver medal in the women's big air. Livia Tano from Switzerland. Things could not have gone better for her. Two golds, what a great return. The rider from Switzerland's had a Europa Cup win. This will be the biggest of the lot, though. Second bronze medal at Lake Placid 2023 for Atsuhiro Suzuki.
Second place, representing Germany,
Moritz Blue picks up his first medal of these games. He was sixth in the slope style, steps it up to the silver medal position. Showing their appreciation for his efforts. Yusai Kaku, the gold medalist. So close in the slope style to a medal. He's been on the World Cup Tour this season. Picked up points in Kür and Big Air back in October. 25th place there, but this will mean a lot to Yusai Kaku.